Now, remember, the school teacher was caught on camera by a student basically lecturing them and cursing them out at the same time. Well, that school teacher has returned back to the institution. Many parents are not happy. Let me remind you of the original video. Here it is.
Society is trying to make you as soft as possible so that everybody feels good about themselves. Like, if you're fat, whose fault is that? Yours. And I'll tell you that straight up. That's because of the things you put in your mouth. That anybody forced it down your throat. But everybody wants to be body positive. Let's celebrate fat people. Why? They just f-ing die because they're fat. Yeah, y'all laugh. This is the truth. Again, don't care. You're fat.
It can be genetic.
That's a excuse. It can be genetic, yeah. Guess what? My entire family's fat. I'm not. I'm one of the most in shape people around you. I do marathons. All my parents are fat. My parents are fat, and so is my brother. That's not genetics. Excuse. That's okay. That's fine. That's the mindset y'all have. Let's find an excuse. It's somebody else's fault. It's always somebody else's fault. I couldn't get to class, coach. Whatever. It's somebody else's fault. It's not your fault. Take responsibility for yourself. Okay? No one cares, especially when you come to my class. And y'all probably should understand that by now. We're almost 20 weeks into school. Some of y'all still don't understand how it operates. Some of y'all still don't understand if you just turn your work in, you'll pass this class. Okay? The people who do, you're like, yeah, it's easy. I don't see how you're failing. But I mean, there's over 50% of this class has failed. That's all it is. And that frustrates me as a person because I just feel like I'm wasting my time talking to a bunch of idiots who don't give. That's frustrating as a teacher. I wish I could be in my position. Never got heads up now because Coach Diffie's throwing the F-bomb out everywhere.
Unprofessional. Derogatory. You know why over 50% of your class is failing, sir? Because you are not a decent educator. That is why. Educators do more than teach. The true art of education is motivation. Digging inside to dig inside. You don't inspire, sir. That is how you operate. Now, there are many who will say, what he's saying is true. We need more people to talk like that to this generation. Really? You want a teacher that calls your child an idiot? Or do you want someone who says, I know they call you an idiot, but you're not one. You're smart. As a matter of fact, you're a damn genius. And talk them up rather than talking them down. That school teacher has now returned to the classroom. Parents at the school have complained to the administrators. And here it is.
You're wasting your time, more importantly. It's not really mine. But I do appreciate those people. But you others clowns, dude, y'all go f yourselves, honestly. You're just wasting my time. You're wasting your time, more importantly. It's not really mine.
Let's put up the picture for math. His name is Coach Mike Diffie. A student posted this profanity and demeaning language he utilized. He was speaking to classmates or his classroom, and students were involved in this conversation. Diffie has now returned to the school. His administrative leave is over. Parents are disappointed. After the incident, one person posted to Facebook about the teacher's alleged violent outburst. He said, and I quote, my son said this is Coach Diffie. And he has always talked to them like that. I also just found out he is the teacher that slammed my son into the wall. My son is telling me a lot now that he has graduated. Another parent told Indisputable his son was berated and vulgarity shouted at him on the field. When the child saw Diffie in class, he says he was further humiliated. He says Diffie encouraged players to pick or bully his son. The parent said he believed Diffie engages in this regular pattern of abuse. A third parent, Ms. Lopez, whose daughter attends Captain Shreve High School, says she complained to the administration and the high school's board about Diffie's behavior. She says she received zero, no follow-up. If we want children to act a certain way, especially teachers and adults, we need to pretty much act even better than the kids. Yes, it's called professionalism. There's a time and place, and I get what he was trying to do. I don't. A good old boy approach, trying to relate to kids, throwing around a few cuss words, but that's not his environment. She added, what if those kids have obesity issues? And he kills himself that day because the teacher couldn't control his mouth. I thought it was completely unprofessional. And I told the board that I'm not out here trying to get this man fired. That's not my goal. My goal is this behavior never happens again. Ms. Lopez, quite reasonable. Let's go to the superintendent, the man in charge, right? At the end of the day, Dr. Gorey, this is your responsibility. It may not have been your fault, but it is now because you refuse to take leadership. Marquell Center, Director of Communication and Marketing, Cottle Parish Public Schools reached back out to Indisputable, said, and I quote, thank you for reaching out. State law prohibits us from commenting further on personnel matters. However, Cottle Parish Public Schools is dedicated to the well-being of our students and will continue our commitment of ensuring that all students have a safe learning environment that allows for their academic growth. You could have kept that statement. So here's what we have, a guy who is not a student advocate, someone acting wholly unprofessional, utilizing profanity, othering students, allegations that he uses students to bully other students, he gets to come back. Isn't that something? You do realize that if a student acted the way Mr. Diffie acted, that student would be expelled for the rest of that year. And if they continued, they would not have a place to go to school. But you accept the behavior of the teacher when you would not accept that behavior from a student. What message are you sending? You see, students aren't always listening, but they are always learning. AB, thoughts?
I mean, if that teacher was someone of color, they would not be in their job right now, right? This is what happens when you listen to Andrew Tate and you take that rhetoric and you spread it across your classroom. It's unproductive. It's pointless. He didn't have any points at all. Just because your family is obese and you're not obese does not mean that obesity cannot be genetic, right? Nothing that you said was wholly accurate. So you're sitting there loud and wrong, inaccurate for no reason. But this is what happens when we pay teachers 35 cents an hour to teach our kids. Any and everybody that has access to a Cracker Jack box will come into the classroom and be responsible for teaching your kids. And so it's just unfortunate the level that our school education is going into, but this is what we have.
Yep, so we shall see. Parents are still outraged. They are pushing back. We will see if it is effective.